I wondered if you could tell us a little bit about why you think the series is already such a big phenomenon and where you're hoping the future of the games takes us.
Yeah, well, Westerns is always the first film genre, you know, and I think there's something about it that that has a universal appeal, like the expanding into the unknown, you know, and living in a lawless world where it's you against nature and what have you. And I think those themes were carried on, and Rockstar translated them beautifully into gaming, you know, and so much so that there hasn't really been many other games approaching the Western genre the same way that Red Dead did. So to be a part of it has been a real, real massive privilege. And yeah, I mean, I don't know where I think Arthur's story has definitely been told, you know, but what Strauss Zelnick, he did confirm it, and I would be very surprised if we've seen the last of that, of this franchise, because, you know, the fans just have responded so well to it. And I remember when we were working on Red Dead 2, and how much I was a big fan of the first Red Dead, and all I was going for was that it would be as liked as the first one. And I think we achieved that, so I'm very, very grateful. But where it would go from now, I have no idea, but I have all confidence in Rockstar Games, and one of the things they never fail to do is to surprise, you know, and they're expert storytellers, and it was a joy working with them. And whether or not I'd be a part of it in the future, I have no idea, but I'm sure they're going to do a great job.
With Red Dead Redemption 2, was that your first experience using mocap?
No, I did it before here, actually, somewhere near Oxford, I believe. It was for a studio. It was a joint production by Rebellion Games and Eidos. And that was about 16 years ago. And we did a game called Shell Shock 2, which is a lot of zombies and Vietnamese and Vietnam War. And it was a lot of fun. And I was fascinated from then about that medium. It's fascinating to me. And to see the way the technology has progressed since has been a real privilege. It's I love it. I love performance capture. I love it a lot. As it gets better and better, it just affords more and more freedom to the performers. It's pretty cool. Takes a lot of imagination, but it's I love it.
Yeah. Do you think it's going to evolve next?
Well, I think voice acting is still a significant part of it, but performance capture is becoming a bigger and bigger and ever increasing section of it. You know, like 20 years ago, it was all exclusively voice acting. Maybe not exclusively, but performance capture is definitely here to stay. And like I was saying earlier, seeing that technology unfold in front of your very eyes has been a massive privilege, you know, and I'm just fascinated by the whole concept of it, because you have a mocap studio and you're in Antarctica in the morning and you're in medieval England the afternoon, and all it changes really is the animators and the developers' imagination. So it's a fantastic medium. And even with COVID too, it's been, you know, it's a lot safer to work in a mocap environment than would you like a typical film set, you know, because you can cheat. People don't need to be standing right next to each other. You know, the animators can do that in post. You can even change the camera angle in post if you want. You know, what you think could be a wide shot could actually turn into a close-up in the end. So bearing that in mind, as an actor, you start to think, well, I know what they think this shot might be now, but that could change in the future. So you tend to lean a bit more towards the theatrical than as the little subtle little nuances of film performance, you know. It's really only in cutscenes where you get close-ups, you know, and most of the time they're going for as wide a shot as possible so that the gamer can see as much of their environment as possible. So it does add for a bit more physicality, I think. But, you know, there's so many different ways to do it, and no two studios do it the same way, and it's really fascinating to see the way different people work and whatnot. I just see it becoming a bigger, bigger part of the video game industry, and we're starting to see that happen with the film industry now too. I think it's only a matter of time before we start seeing mocap suits filmed in tandem with on set. You know, we're kind of seeing that already with Mark Ruffalo and as the Hulk, and I think Disney and Marvel have done some really fascinating stuff. And now with Obi-Wan Kenobi, I can't wait. That technology that they did for The Mandalorian, that was amazing. So yeah, on-set location filming, I think, is becoming less and less necessary. But when that happens, the performer needs to be more imaginative. If you're in a cold environment, You got to remember to be cold. If it's a hot, sweaty environment, you got to be swatting flies every once in a while. So I think motion capture, when you get experienced at it and you start to remember those little details, and that brings the realism to the audience that I think we're still going to need. But as far as the technology is going, I have no idea where they're going with it, but I'm sure it's going to keep going. Yeah.
About motion capture and the possibilities. Do you feel that this has helped you adapt in such a way that you can improvise a bit more and bring sort of a little bit more element of yourself into the character?
Absolutely. I mean, some like I said, some studios do it differently. But the performer can really bring in a lot more nuances of their own personality, if you will. But again, it depends on the script. You know, you work with the script you're given. And you can complain and argue with it, but, you know, that usually doesn't bode well. You know, we've all got jobs to do, so it's our job to do them. Absolutely. I think there's a lot of freedom. Performance capture lends a lot of freedom to all aspects of the performance. Absolutely.
Well,
I remember one line I really liked was, how did it go again? It's Arthur talking to John, and he's saying, you know, I was the prize pony once, but this life, this way, well, we're the last, I reckon, and we ain't long for it. Because Arthur knew that the Wild West was coming to an end, and that's a big source of conflict in Red Dead 2, because some people acknowledge that this way of life is coming to an end, and other people can't acknowledge that, and that causes a lot of strife. But Arthur saw the writing on the wall, and that's my favorite line.